I see a lot of content creators telling you not to reroll. And so I'm left wondering like,
what? Rerolling is half the game, boys.
But I kind of get where they're coming from, and let's touch on that today. Hi, welcome back to another Punishing Grey Raven video. My name is Lace, and today we are going to be talking about rerolling. I'm going to keep this as concise as possible. First, I'm going to go through the facts, go through the steps as to like what you should exactly do. And then after that, I'm going to tell you guys the different methods that we can use to reset. If you guys are veteran rerollers, you guys should already know them. It's like the salting method. It's the routing method, the change ID method, as well as the last one, which was cloning. And I always forget about cloning because cloning never freaking works for me. On top of that, let me kind of talk through the strategy as well. So I'm talking like who are your reroll targets, potentially tier lists, but more around the information surrounding it so you can make a like informed decision. All right. So without further ado, let's jump into the video and let me kind of spell out the facts. So in this video, I'm just going to be referring to like my footage from CBT because I wasn't lucky enough to get into the content creator server. Hura Games, if you guys are watching, please, like I'm your boy, please hit me up. But I'm gonna stop whining and let's get into the content. So when you first get into the game, you're gonna be going through like a whole bunch of tutorials and all of that. As you can see, this account right now is at 1-2. And so what you need to do is make sure that this is past 1-12. Make sure you complete 1-12 as well so that you can unlock the rolling. And so the time it takes to actually get to 1-12 to like finally roll, it's about like 20 to 25 minutes. And so when you are finished with 1-12, what you're gonna do is you're gonna come over to this screen over here. As you can see, there's a story, daily, weekly, and event. Hopefully there should be a bunch of stuff for you to collect and just collect everything. Essentially, what I'm telling you to do after you clear 1-12 is look in every place possible that you can for all of the different missions and collect those rewards. So there's gonna be some stuff in the mailbox up here, and there's probably gonna be some stuff in the missions. So as you can see over here, this is what I was referring to. So this is the event thing, and you can see that you're getting a whole bunch of purple tickets. And so again, after hitting 1-12, you will have enough for a 10 pull. And so this is where it starts getting a bit spicy. So again, with those purple tickets, we are actually able to use it only on this banner. So this is the beginner banner. And so on top of these purple tickets, you can actually see that there are black tickets. And so what these black tickets are, they are essentially like your universal currency, which you can use to convert to like more rolling tickets or like to refresh your stamina. And so as you can see, you technically can convert these like black tickets into these purple tickets. However, that's not really it because that is for the beginner banner. And that's not really where like the true big, big value is. And if I scroll forward a little bit, you'll be able to see that this guy is using the event construct res. I don't know why it's called res, but essentially this is like the special banner. So what this means is like when there are going to be new characters, for example, Alpha and whoever, they're going to actually show up here. And to roll on these banners, you need those like orangey tickets. These ones over here, you can see like, I don't know if you can see it, but it's limited. And so these limited tickets are also derived from these black tickets. And so what does this mean? It means that you should save your black tickets for these limited yellow orange ones. And so this is kind of where it gets a little bit big brain, especially for the re-rolling. So typically speaking, we have like two options. Well, we do have three, but let me go through the first two. So just a reminder, after we finish 1-12, we are going to have 12 standard tickets. So 12 of those purple tickets and 4 of the limited tickets. Okay, so there is actually an order in which we should like roll these tickets in. If you roll those 4 limited tickets onto this S. Lee banner and you manage to successfully hit S. Lee, then what you can do is you can actually save all of those gold tickets up and like not use them except for like when Alpha comes long or other of those units. This also gives you the opportunity to like actually clear out the beginner banner with only purple tickets. However, if you are going to try do that, it's actually going to take you about 1 month to clear this entire banner just by using these guys over here. And so therefore, if it's going to take you 1 month to clear this using only purple tickets, it means that you can only use your S selector after 1 month because you're going to want to see what you get from here first so that you don't get a dupe with your S selector. For example, in this scenario, you pulled S Lee in your 4 pulls for the limited banner. You're going to dump purple tickets into this banner for 1 month and then you're going to see who you get. For example, from this banner, you get S Kamui. And so after you get S Kamui, you're going to go over to your S selector that they're going to give us and then you're going to pick S Live. And then so you've got a really strong start. However, obviously the downside of this is that you are not playing with like really the optimal units. You may be investing into units that you don't really want to use and all of that. However, that is the first option and is probably like the greediest one. And the reason it's greedy is because you save on these black cards and you use those black cards towards the other banner, the limited ones. The other option is to reroll on this one over here. And so what exactly does that mean? It means that we are trying to hit with those 12 tickets, like your target character. And so for example, with those 12 pulls that we get from like the 1-12 run, if we hit like S Kamui, for example, on like day 1, we can then use the S Selector right after and pick up like S Live. This is also 100% a very, very valid strategy. On top of that, it also means that those four pulls that you would be putting into that S Lee banner, you can now put it into Alpha when she comes. And on top of that, you don't have to worry about dumping more of these black cards into these purple cards to put into here. So honestly, guys, I know that was a lot to take in, so let me kind of summarize it up. Option one is that you roll on this one over here on the Lee banner. If you manage to hit Lee, then you can actually save from here and you will start the game with three SSRs. Lee, the beginner banner SSR, and the S Selector SSR. It could be Lee, it could be anyone else, but like Lee, for example. This is the exceptionally greedy option because it actually takes you so long to clear out that beginner banner with just purple tickets. And so therefore, let's go to option two, which is to roll 12 tickets into this standard banner or the beginner banner. Roll 12 so that you know who you get and then so you can spend your S Selector immediately. This method allows you to start with two SSRs, which is kind of like the normal rate, but it technically also gives you four of those limited tickets that you don't have to put into that lead banner. Okay, hopefully that makes sense. And if it doesn't, just drop a comment below or come by the Discord and I'll try explaining it a little bit better. But otherwise, let's move on to our third reroll, and that is to actually reroll onto this like weapon banner. So as you can see, this weapon banner actually uses these pink tickets. And the reason why you would roll on this banner is so that you can get the weapon for like your favorite characters or something like that. On top of that, it also technically has like the highest rates. But on top of that, you can actually transfer your weapons around. And so like, it's a little bit more flexible than like upgrading into a character. However, the issue with this is that it's a weapon. I don't know if anyone really likes to reroll for a weapon. And so therefore, I really would not advise on this one. Out of these three reroll methods, I would really recommend like the method two, which is rerolling the 12 onto the standard banner or the beginner banner. If you're feeling a little bougie, if you're feeling a little bit hardcore, then roll for like the method one, in which you're looking for S Lee or like literally anyone else on that limited banner. And if you're feeling extra, you can go try for the weapon one, but I honestly would not recommend this one. All right, so with that in mind, who exactly should I reroll for? If I hop over to here, I'm gonna show you all of the possibilities, which are all of these characters here. And so if this is your first time seeing these characters, let me give you a quick introduction. We've got S Kamui, which is a tank. We've got S Liv, who is a healer. We've got S Lee, who is a DPS. After that, we have S Karenina and S Nanami, who are like fire DPSs and a tank respectively. The fact of the matter is that at the end game, you're gonna be building like pretty much every single character. However, there is kind of like slight preferences, if we can put it that way. What I'm gonna say is that S Kamui and S Liv probably have the longest shelf life. I believe even now in CN, S Kamui is still like the premier dark tank. On top of that, we've got S Liv, who also has quite a long shelf life because she is an exceptional healer. But of course, I know a lot of you are probably like, well, I don't want to reroll for a healer. And so in that regard, I would probably go for S Kamui. Now, as for the other ones, we've got S Lee over here, and S Lee is like a physical DPS. Physical DPS, unfortunately, old mate S Lee is just about to get outclassed by Alpha. And if you guys don't know who Alpha is, let me show you real quick. As you can see, this one is Alpha, aka Lucia Crimson Abyss. And if I come down here, you see that the class is a DPS, but not only that, the element is physical. Unfortunately, with this overlap, like a physical DPS, like she completely replaces S Lee. And so it's for this reason that I would not recommend going for S Lee, because he's about to get power crept by Alpha, like straight up, the first banner right after his. Okay, coming back to these guys over here, we've got Karenina as well as Nanami. A long time ago, it was actually recommended to take Karenina because Karenina is a really, really strong fire DPS. However, the issue of Karenina and Nanami is kind of like, well, they're not really made for each other, but if you have one, you kind of want the other. And it really locks you into a fire team. So if you guys don't know how teams work in this game, essentially you want three characters of the same element. For example, you've got Karenina, you know what? Let me just call him Ember. You've got Ember, you've got Pulse, and for example, you might have Padma as well. The reason you want to actually make these like technically mono teams is because they have like element resist shred. And so there are some skills or effects and stuff which are like, will decrease like the enemy's like fire defense by 15%, something like that. And so therefore it's in your best interest to go like mono teams. Another massive reason is that like playing a tank is not really that fun. And unfortunately, Nanami just doesn't do that much damage. And so if you got her, you'd kind of be like, well, building around a fire tank. And so to build around a fire tank, you want a fire DPS, and that's just Karenina, right? Honestly, I think people trash on Karenina a little bit too much. I think Karenina is fine. However, I wouldn't recommend Nanami just because like it's gonna be a lot easier to clear with like a DPS. And so that's kind of my personal tier list. So I'd be going for like S Kamui first and then S Liv. And then after that, I'd probably go for Karenina, Nanami, and then S Lee. And this is all assuming that I'm going with the method two, which is like rolling on the beginner banner. I think my perfect reroll would be just to get S Kamui or S Liv from like the beginner banner and then go over to the S Selector and get the other one. I personally would be really happy with that, and I'd call that reset Mara finish. All right, so that should be the tier list out of the way. And the last thing to talk about is what exactly do we do to reset our progress when we don't get what we want? Okay, guys, typically speaking, there are three methods to do this. So the first one is called the salting one. But to be honest, about salting, about the root method, about the clone method, honestly, I've actually already covered all of these topics, but for another game. I think I covered these topics for Alchemy Stars and they are going to be exactly the same. For the salting method, what you're going to do is you're either going to go into here or go into this cogwheel. I can't remember where it is. What you're essentially going to do is you're going to have a crappy reroll. You're going to bind it to like a Google account. After you bind it, you're going to then log out and then you're going to start the game again as a guest. And so after you become a guest again, you go all the way through to 112 again, do your rolls and see if it's another crappy account. If it's another crappy account, bind it to that same Google address, but with like a dot or something in it. Again, I will drop these videos down in the description below, but like it is exactly the same process. As for the instance cloning method, I guess I can show you guys right now. So let me just like bring up my BlueStacks. So we've got this guy over here. And essentially what we do is we create like one of these instances. So for example, the PCRD note, instead, let's like pretend that PGR is actually installed onto this one. I'm going to call this one PGR base. So in this instance, what's happened is that I've installed Punishing Gray Raven and I have not opened it at all. What I'm going to do after that is I'm going to click this one, which is clone instance. And I'm going to like clone like maybe like two instances maybe. And then so what you're going to get is you're going to get like a bunch of clones. And then so you play through those clones and then you see if you get something good. And if you don't get anything good, you delete that clone. After you delete that clone, you come back over here and then you clone the instance again to make a new copy. And then so you can do that over and over and over. And hopefully you'll actually end up with like an account that you like with one of the clones that you made. And then the last one, the root method, I actually don't know if this one works, but let me show you what I'm planning to do. So as you can see here, and again, this one is untested, but I have PGR installed. I've got this app called Change Device ID, and this Moomoo instance is actually rooted. So if I go into here, settings, and there should be like a root switch right here, everything is in order. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open PGR. I'm going to play through. I'm going to get to 112. And then after I get to 112, I'm going to roll. And if I'm not happy with the account, I'm going to try clear like all of the app data and all of that. But not only that, I'm going to go to this app, Change Device ID, and then I'm going to go click new Android ID. And then as you can see, the current Android ID is that. The new one is that. So if I hit apply, it's actually going to change it. And so this is okay. This is just asking for root access. I'm going to allow it. Remember the choice forever. And so as you can see, my device ID has been changed. So this is now become this one over here, DDBC, which was like previously over here. So if you want me to show you again, FD0. So this is the new one that I'm about to get. So I'm going to apply. And so this one should technically become FD0. So I'm going to click apply and it should be FD0. And so there it is. Okay. So after that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go home. I'm going to go into the settings and then I'm going to go into the app data. So apps over here, and I'm going to find PGR. Fine. PGR should be right here. And then I'm going to come into storage and I'm going to clear the data and clear the cache here. So what this means is that for the root method, there are three steps. I got to clear the data, I got to clear the cache, and then I got to do this change device ID. Again, this is not tested, but it has worked on every single game that I've tried since I've learned about this method. And so I really hope this one is going to work because I really like don't like the cloning method. Again, I'm going to drop links to like all of these methods down in the description below. Hopefully it'll work for you. But otherwise, I think that's actually it for this video. So let's start wrapping things up. And so guys, I've got a secret question for you guys. And did I convince you to reroll? Because if you don't reroll, it means that you're going to be putting all of your tickets into like that beginner banner. And then you might get S Karenina or like S Nanami. And that's completely okay. To be honest, if you like them, like don't let me have talked you out of them. Like just go for them. So yeah, let me know guys. Are you guys rerolling? Are you guys not rerolling? Because if there is any game that is not rerolling for, like it is this game. I completely respect it if you guys do not reroll in this game. But yeah, let me know down in the comments below and I would really appreciate it because it means that you've actually watched all the way to the end of the video. And so as always, thank you so much for that. But otherwise, if you found this video kind of helpful or mildly entertaining, then please consider a like, a sub, a comment, a follow. You guys already know what it is. Share it with your friends. If you're feeling a bit lonely, come join the Discord. If you would like to support the channel, there are a couple of affiliate links down in the description below. On top of that, we do have a membership thing, which gets you a neat little badge as well as some cool emojis. But otherwise, as my PS4 once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.